we have been together for 7 years, 8 years married.
8 years.
Dated for 7 years before that. And lived a lot of life together, grown up together. We're both from really strong Christian families. My dad's a pastor. And so we had really great examples throughout our childhood with church and just what it looks like to follow Christ. And so when we met in church, and we experienced good things during that time period. This was in high school, but also experienced some hurt and some confusion with how people said that they were believers, but then did not behave that way, didn't act that way, especially when it came to loving people, no matter who they were. And so when we experienced that, it just left us in a state of like, well, what's the purpose of the church, and what is it going to look like in our lives? At that point, we moved to college, and our college experience was very interesting. Probably we did not get involved in church. We experienced like drive-through church, where we were able to come in, no one knew us, and we left, and that was about the extent of our Christian walk. But God was faithful through that, and we got married at the end of college and moved to San Antonio, where we found a church plant that was really redeeming for us.
Yeah, so we moved to Texas and you know, really opened ourselves up to have God show us whatever, you know, he had for us, I guess. And knowing that, like, we both carried quite a bit of hurt and confusion over what church had or should have meant to us in our lives, and that we both saw the need for restoration in our hearts. And so the Lord was wonderful to us and brought us to a tiny church plant where we experienced the richness of community in our, just the most genuine way that we've ever known. And honestly just didn't know until then that that's really what the church should be in a believer's life, to know and be known with other believers. And so that was hugely transformative for us. And yeah, we just grew to see ourselves in just a really different way in what we're called to as
believers.
We
experienced a lot of growth, like individually, even in our walk with Christ. And that was because we were involved with other believers constantly. I mean, it was constant. And we were serving, we were living out what God tells us in Scripture, and we experienced life more full.
Yeah, absolutely. So we lived in San Antonio for about 3 years, and then made the decision to move, to Maine, of all places, which is very different than Mississippi or Texas. Very unchurched states, like the least church state in the country, and experienced a lot of loneliness in Maine. It was beautiful, but also just really lonely times. Spent about a year there and then moved back to Mississippi, where we really looked forward to finding a church and having that, again, finding that sense of community. And unexpectedly really struggled to find that in Mississippi. We visited a lot of churches, and after living places outside of the South, I think we came to see the sort of cultural role that church has in a lot of people's lives here, where most people are comfortable not having church be at the center of their life. It's something that they do, but that sharing of your life in a really meaningful way with other believers is something that we really struggled to find. Mm-hmm. And so we did settle at another church for several years, and it was fine, but again, we just craved more because we knew that that was possible. We experienced it, and we didn't know really what we were looking for, but we kind of knew that when we found it, we would know, because we'd experienced it before. And so we heard through some mutual friends, as we were sort of asking, should we find another church, that Gray City was known for community, and that they had known some people who had experienced like really rapid growth and like relationships.
And our ears perked up.
And we were like, what? Like, tell us more.
Yes, let's do that.
And so, yeah, we came to Gray City for the first time in February 2023. And our first Sunday, after being there for 15 minutes, we were like, this is different than any other church we've been to here. And that we're very attentive, like, that whole Sunday. And at the end of it, we both looked at each other and like, this is where God wants us to be. This is for us. And we just, yeah, saw something really genuine in the interactions between other people that we observed, and how many people talked to us, and just what that felt like. And it just felt really real. And so,
so we did discover Gray City,
yeah,
and learned to make sure that everything was on the up and up as far as, you know, theology and stuff went. And then we said, this is home.
Yeah. And we said, we're going to do this. And so we got plugged into a community group right away and started serving, which is awesome. And I think really, yeah, are experiencing, again, that same sort of transformation within us as individuals and together experience the fullness that God would have for us.
Yeah, I think something that I've learned through this process is understanding that God gives us instructions through Scripture, not for the sake of rules or expectations, but because He created us, He knows us, and He knows that it will benefit us, it will enrich our lives, it will give us that life abundance, and our life is fuller. Being obedient to Christ.
I think because of the amount of life that we've lived together and the experiences we've had in church and sort of out of church, we've seen what our life looks like in community and out of community, essentially, with and without that sort of genuine sharing life with other believers. And the past several years for us here have been pretty challenging. I mean, the pandemic's obviously challenging for everyone in different ways. The last like year and a half, I have been dealing with some issues from my core family, some really hard things that have been really isolating and lonely. And for the first year of that or so, we did not have community, and it was incredibly difficult and challenging walking through that essentially alone. We, you know, having each other but no outside encouragement or support, and that was really what spurred us on to say we know better than this. Mm-hmm. Like God has more, so much more for us if we would just open ourselves up,
yeah,
to be vulnerable and share our lives and what's really going on with other people.
And we became parents, and so that was also
right.
That's life-changing.
Absolutely.
And we knew that we needed people to speak life into our day-to-day.
Yeah, and the truth. Yeah,
yeah, the truth. Like, just reorienting us, yeah, to the truth. And community group has done that incredibly. It is not so many... I think so many times you think it's going to be life-taking when you add something to your schedule, but it is absolutely life-giving.
Yeah.
And it is something that we cannot imagine. We hate when we have to miss it.
Yeah.
Because it's like, man, we've missed out on something,
yeah,
that helps us in our week.
Yeah, and just having that that group who just looks after each other so well and is genuinely, you know, interested and caring for what's happening in your lives and asking, you know, and praying for each other about what's going on. Like, it's made such a big difference in our lives. And, it's been incredibly transformative.